We gotta reflect on the what Ralph said about if he could do it over again, he'd leave early, get drafted by the Lakers. Okay, so there's the story, obviously, maybe most known is in 82 when you were thinking about leaving early, if the Lakers could swing a deal with San Diego to get the rights to the pick to draft you. But was there, I'm trying to think back to 79 when you're coming out of high school, was there another opportunity? Like, weren't there multiple opportunities for Lakers to try to bring you on early before?
Well, yeah, there were. So, I mean, the 1 year, so 1 year being drafted, it was between, so the first year was me or Kevin McHale. We beat Kevin McHale in the 1979-80 NIT. Kevin McHale, Randy Brouwer, crew. And that's when Red Auerbach came to my parents' house with $1 million in a briefcase and said, here, you can play for the mighty Boston Celtics.
Who did what?
Red Auerbach. So I know you know Sid Maxwell.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
We'll do something else. But Sid, I did him on our podcast as well. He said to me, he said, big fella, because a couple of things. One, Red came to Cedric and Bird and said, we're going to go to Virginia and try to lure Ralph Sampson to come to the Boston Celtics. And Max and Bird said, we ain't going down there and do all that. We don't do it. So Fitzgerald and Red came down with $1 million in a briefcase, put it on my parents' table, and said, you can come play for the mighty Boston Celtics here this year if you come out of school. So McHale wouldn't have gone to Boston's at that point in time. So I decided to stay in school. Now, the next year,
take that money.
And I probably should have back then, but I didn't think I was quite ready. Between my freshman and sophomore in Virginia, I gained 15 pounds of muscle, so I was ready back then. Then we go to the Final Four next year. So next year is a coin flip. It's between the Lakers and Indiana. Now, Coop, now that you know all the political stuff of the game, you know the Lakers gonna get that pick.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just the way it goes. How did Patrick Ewing get to New York? Come on. Coin flip, come on, that had to happen, politically. So that next year, it was me or James Worthy. I was number one player in the country. I was first pick. If I'd have came out, I'd have played with you, but the twin tie was with Kareem and Magic and the Crook, which is probably what I should have done.
Uh-huh.
Then I look back, of course, with the right thing, but I came back again. The next year, it was me and Isaiah. Isaiah went to Detroit. Me and Isaiah was on the phone. Not cell phone, because we didn't have a home phone. I said, okay, great. You're coming out, big fella. You're coming out with Jockey. And I said, I don't know, Isaiah. I don't know what I'm going to do, whatever. So I didn't come out then. Isaiah goes to Detroit, and I end up going to Houston in my senior year. So all those guys, whatever, I tell them all the time, you should thank me, because I came out sometime. Something would have changed. When I did my Hall of Fame speech with when they were out there, and Pat Riley said, Pat, I'm sorry to get to play for you, Magic. Sorry to get to play for you. I should have came out. Y'all wouldn't have had James Worthy, and everybody laughed, but. You know, that's the way history goes. That's the way it works. But yeah, I would have loved to play out there in California for sure. And then I was being traded. So if you remember, in Houston, we didn't have a guard. So they were trying to get Lord Norm Nixon. to Houston for a trade. And the Lakers wanted me to – they wanted a trade, and they wouldn't pull that trigger.